Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And today we are going to do second try with the exploding grinder discs. And now we have safety screen, so it's much safer.
We can be here.
No, I'm just joking. We just put here this to see will it go through, and we are going to be far away. And we have pretty target-rich environment today. So first, I think this is 6 mm polycarbonate. Then we have 10 mm plywood. IKEA, what is the table's name?
Luck.
And then we have some watermelons. The first watermelon has safety shield, and it's B-rated shield. I didn't know, but safety glasses and face shields, they have ratings, and F is the worst. And I think the safety glasses were like really poor, and they're not designed to stop anything like this. But this is B glass, so I think it's like pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Then next watermelon, it has helmet. Then we have some clear ballistic gel that isn't very clear anymore. And then we have some bottles full of ice or water. Frozen ice.
Yeah.
Yeah. And first disc, this is 6 mm thick grinding disc. So it's 6 times heavier than the last time. And I have more straps here, and the mounting is now much more stronger. And it's done really well. It's like as well balanced as you can make these. And yeah, I think that's about it. I'm going to crank the machine on full power, and it's capable of spinning 30,000 revolutions per minute, 5 times faster than those should spin. So if it goes that speed, there is no chance that this is still here. And as you saw on the last video, this is extremely dangerous, and we are here in the concrete bunker because of that. And don't ever try anything like this, or don't ever remove the seal from your grinder. And Anni, what is your opinion? What is going to happen here?
I think mayhem will happen.
I think it's not going to go through this. What is your opinion?
I agree.
But all the rest of the stuff, anything that gets hit is going to be ruined. Even including the plywood and the face shield, everything is going to be ruined. But this is going to stop them. Okay. Here we go. That didn't sound good. That was terrible sound.
Yeah.
Absolutely terrible.
Much worse than last time.
I think it's going to be really bad.
Yeah.
Hey! The blast... Did the blast screen stop it? Hey!
Wow.
That's pretty tough.
Yeah.
Whoa. Hey, Anni, I'm going to save the high speed.
Yeah.
I have just one charger, so I have to save this fast. Hey, but we hit the... Anni, we hit the face shield. I think that was the best thing that we wanted to hit. Okay, those are now saving. And let's have a look what we made.
Damages.
Yeah. So things that got hit. This got hit. And I think tear on the plywood is shrapnel from this hit.
Mm-hmm.
But I have to say, that the polycarbonate, it's no joke.
Yeah.
Anything from the press doesn't fly that fast.
Yeah.
And then the IKEA table got hit there.
Whoa!
And I think the face shield melon was the only melon that got hit.
Oh no. And this time the machine is totally okay.
Yeah, it didn't break. I think we can just load new disc in and try again in case we hit something else.
Okay, I was able to estimate the speed from the footage. It was a bit hard because the disc is black. And it was just slightly faster than the last time. The disc is so much heavier that it took a long time to accelerate. But the heavier mass and the slightly faster speed, they clearly make a difference on the hits, because this time the watermelon didn't get cut. It just exploded. Okay, and then the color camera. And I have to say that I'm surprised how well I was able to film with the Kronos high-speed cameras. The monochrome camera is really good on the cloudy days. It doesn't need a lot of light. But here is the actual explosion. And as you can see, the watermelon really doesn't like the grinding disc. But the polycarbonate, it's no problem at all for it. And the markings on the plywood, they are actually not from any ricochets from the polycarbonate, but from like smaller stuff flying straight from the grinder. Okay, so here it goes.
I guess it hits the bottles.
Yeah, no major hits. Oh!
What?
The helmet melon is gone. And check the plywood.
Oh no.
Check the plywood.
Oh no.
Oh no.
That's not good.
I'm going to save the high speed. Yeah, so it's three pieces. One through plywood. One here and one to the watermelon. Okay, so I think this is also a good lesson. Don't hide behind the plywood. You would think that the plywood is better than plastic, but this is like twice as thick. And I think this like just makes more dangerous because now there is lot of like wood shrapnel also. Yeah. And then the helmet, I think it went through, yeah.
Yeah.
I think this is about as hard as the face shield. Mm-hmm, so probably good idea to have both. I think this was the first one. Do you see another one?
And here we have one.
Ah, here. Yeah, there is ducks too. But it doesn't leave mark on the concrete at all.
Okay, and then the high speed. And the plywood is absolutely my favorite. It doesn't even move when the disc goes through. So that's crazy. It didn't slow it down at all. And the helmet is also pretty nice. There you can clearly see that the helmet really does something. Because it like bends quite a lot when hit. And I think the strap things actually catch the disc. It doesn't fly through the whole thing. And here you can see the wood shrapnel nicely when the disc goes through the plywood. And that plywood stuff is flying also pretty fast, so it actually can be even worse to be behind thin plywood with stuff like this. And the helmet is flying also there. Yeah, pretty nice.
So I don't know how fast these spin. I think I was able to calculate it on edit, so you know. But the heavier discs are even more dangerous, I would say. The first one's been really fast and it exploded really hard. And I think with the small grinder, it's going to probably start faster than the router. And I think it can explode there. So, again, once more time, don't remove the guard. I think you can, even if you think that it would be safe to like use the small grinder without the guard, I think just the chance that you can accidentally put large disc there and turn it on, that's like already too much risk to remove the guard. And even the better shielding didn't help at all. I think there's less remaining from the watermelons than the last time. It didn't help at all. What is your opinion about everything?
Pretty good mayhem.
Pretty good mayhem, but you were right. You said that it's going to be mayhem. And if you have some other ideas about tools that we should spin too fast, please let us know. We have the we have good place to try. We have the machine here, and I can make like special stupid mounts to install those. So if you want to see like some possible work accidents, how bad they would be, just let us know and we will try.
Yeah,
but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.
And for today's extra content, small teaser from the next Sunday's video. This is going to be so stupid and great. So subscribe the channel to see this.